Hey guys, welcome back to another can review. Today we're checking out the Southern Grist Real Recognized Real. So this is a brown ale. It is a big brown ale. It's a 9.1% brown ale.
Pretty big.
That's big bear. Better recognize. Doesn't say anything on the can other than, wow. Ooh, it's going. Pour that immediately.
So this one's brewed with like cinnamon and graham crackers and vanilla. So it sounds kind of like a s'mores. And toasted coconut. So like an almond joy s'mores.
Well, I could already smell it from the can. It's like coconut, waves of coconut. Yeah, wow. Pronounced coconut right up front. Get that chocolate malt happening as well. No hoppiness whatsoever. Yeah, coconut is the main player for sure on the aroma at least. There's only one way to figure out what it tastes like, so here we go.
Cheers.
Cheers. There's a little bit of like that chocolatey. It tastes like it smells.
Yeah.
Really.
Pretty much. I'm getting, I think the coconut mixed with the cinnamon gives it this kind of like sweet coconut.
Yeah, it is sweet. Yeah, there's a sweet cloyingness to it, and it's a little boozy, so it's gonna be one that sticks kind of with you. Whoa, what was that? What did I say? So yeah, it's a little bit boozy. It's definitely coconutty. That's the main thing I'm tasting right away is that coconut. Graham cracker and cinnamon. I'm not getting that so much, but I am getting some chocolatiness to it.
I think graham cracker is kind of like a hard flavor to nail.
Yeah, what is this supposed to be, a texture or a flavor?
I'm not sure. I mean, if you think about what graham crackers taste like, they're kind of just like, it's like a honey biscuit almost.
Yeah.
Which is kind of hard to imitate.
I mean, biscuitiness would be the closest thing, I would think.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah, honey biscuits. I never, when people say that that's in a beer, I never get that flavor as something I can pick out. I think it's just really, it's so far in the background there that every other flavor, especially that coconut, which is really pronounced, takes over. Mm-hmm. So maybe it's like a mouthfeel thing they're talking about? I don't know.
Kind of like a dessert brown ale.
It is, yeah.
I think it's kind of dangerous because for 9.1% beer, this is quite sweet.
It hides the alcohol quite well, but yeah. It does taste, there is this like kind of booziness to it for sure. Like for sure. And you know, brown ales aren't really like the heaviest style of beer ever, so you know, they're generally pretty light. And I think they brewed this one without coconut and without being a like 9% beer.
The bartender that was helping us out, I think she told me that it's the same base that they use.
Oh.
And then this is an Imperial version of that standard brown ale.
Got it. So this one is brewed with lactose, so that's where that smoothness comes in. Double vanilla, cinnamon, toasted coconut, graham crackers, and lactose. That's a big boy right there. Yeah, it's a coconut chocolate bomb kind of thing. But it still has this like light character to it, but yet it's still boozy kind of. It's weird. That's a weird one for me.
I feel like this would be great in like an Imperial Stout.
This would be great over ice cream. Vanilla bean ice cream beer float with this in it would be pretty good. I'm not a fan of the booziness, but I'll let that one slide. The rest of it tastes pretty good. I don't like coconut either, though. But it isn't bad.
Maybe if they added almond to it, it would taste like an almond joy.
Oh, can you do that? Is that a thing? Almond flavoring?
Yes, that is definitely a thing.
Good Take idea. Notes, my friends. Take notes. Anyways, that does it from us. If you're interested in more craft beer reviews or beer event coverage, be sure to click that little subscribe button. Once we hit 200 subscribers, we'll be doing a sweet giveaway, so stay tuned. Until next time, stay crafty. Cheers.